हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस नैनो स्केल सिस्टम्स एंड इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल कवर दैट बेसिक्स ऑफ नैनो टेक्नोलॉजी एंड सिंथेसिस मेथड टू सिंथेसाइज डिफरेंट नैनो मटेरियल्स एंड हिस्ट्री ऑफ नैनो टेक्नोलॉजी एंड सम एप्लीकेशंस। सो Before I start the main topic, we should know what actually the nano systems are. So for this, we have to understand what is the nano. Basically, the nano means 1 millionth, and it is Greek analogous for the word dwarf, which means small. The measurements at this level is of the order of nanometers. For example, a strand of human hair is roughly 75,000 nanometer across. Similarly, 10 hydrogen atoms line up end to end and make up 1 nanometer. So the field of nanoscience is not new, and scientists have been doing research in this field for hundreds of years. Some examples are stained glass windows found in medieval churches contain different size gold nanoparticles incorporated into the glass. And second example, Einstein, as a part of his doctoral dissertation, calculated the size of sugar molecule as 1 nanometer. So these examples prove that this nanotechnology is not new, because it has been studied long back. So now, what are the defining features of nanotechnology? That means if you want to introduce some new definition, then we should know some international measurement and standards. So these are few features. Nanotechnology involves research and technology development at the 1 nanometer to 100 nanometer range. And number two, nanotechnology creates and uses structure that have novel properties because of their small size. And number three, nanotechnology build on the ability to control or manipulate the atomic scale. So from this, you can see point one and three are straightforward, but point number two is not straightforward, because when we go to nanoscale, the interaction and physics between atoms display exotic properties that do not at larger scales, which means that when you move from bulk to nano, then some properties may be appear or disappear depending on the systems or the properties. For example, a gold nanoparticle has a color, melting point and chemical property different from macroscopic gold bricks. That's because the interaction of gold atoms in the larger gold bricks average out, thus changing the overall properties and appearance of the object. A single gold nanoparticle is free from the averaging effect of countless other gold atoms. Means, if you see the example of gold brick, then you can find the averaging out effect of different nanoparticles or atoms. But a single nanoparticle is free from the averaging effect. That's why they have different properties. Now, this is the length scale in physics. You can see in this slide or here that how the different length scales found in the nature. For example, if you see that you are in the top of this, that is the you are here, that is 1.75 meter, or this is almost 1 meter. And from here in the bottom scale, that is the hydrogen atom, that is of the order of 0.1 nanometer, and different scales are there. For example, fly, that is centimeter or millimeter range, and hair diameter that I told earlier, 75,000 nanometer, and this some other examples. So you can see RBCs and different scales, how they go from nano to bulk. Now, the brief history of nanotechnology. So we divided into three parts. First, the Bayesian, second, the believing, and third, the nanostructures. So in 1959, Richard Feynman proclaimed there is plenty of room at the bottom, outlining the prospects for atomic engineering. And in 1981, Gerd Binning and Henrik Rohrer of IBM at Zurich Research Laboratory create the scanning tunneling microscope, enabling the researchers to see the and manipulate atoms for the first time. That means without seeing, we cannot assume or we cannot understand what actually the nano particles or the nano systems. So this is the first instrument to visualize the nano atoms or the nano systems. Now in 1985, Robert F. Curl and Croteau and Richard E. Smalley discovered the soccer ball shaped molecule made of carbon 0.77 nanometer wide. Now the application of nanotechnology. Nanotechnology interdisciplinary or multidisciplinary, chemists, physicists and medical doctors are working alongside engineers, biologists to determine the applications, direction and development of nanotechnology. Industries such as materials manufacturing, computer manufacturing and healthcare will all benefit from nanotechnological advances or the advances made in the nano field. Basically, there are two approaches to fabricate the nanoscale systems. First one is the top-down approach, in which first work at a larger scale and then cut away to reach nanoscale systems. I mean, top-down means first you see on the bulk and you cut away the system to reach at the a smaller or the nanoscale. Bottom-up approach, building the product one atom at a time. This self-assembly process can be time-consuming. That means in this you have to combine atom by atom and you can make the nano material. Now the physical length scale nanostructure. The transport properties of a device are determined by a set of characteristic length and their relationship to the physical dimension of the device. Actually, these are the length scales below which the material so the nano technology or the nano systems. So conductor shows ohmic behavior when it is in dimension greater than all length scales. But there are four length scales. Number one, mean free path. Basically, the average distance an electron travels before it experiences elastic scattering, which destroys its initial momentum. The dominant elastic scattering mechanism is impurity scattering. It is related to the momentum time, relaxation time, tau tr by lm, that is b tau r, where b is the average carrier speed. Now the phase relaxation length, the average distance an electron travels before information about its initial phase is lost. This is inelastic scattering and it is responsible for the dephasing and the occurs in electron-phonon interaction. In high mobility semiconductor, the phase relaxation time tau phi can be the same order or shorter than the momentum relaxation time, which I described earlier, tau tr, and it is given by L phi is equal to Vf tau phi, where Vf is the Fermi velocity. Now the third one is a de Broglie wavelength. An electron with wave number k has a de Broglie wavelength lambda. In terms of energy, it is lambda square is equal to h square upon 2me, where m star is the effective mass of the electron. And de Broglie wavelength is the scale at which quantum mechanical effects become important. Means if any system has the dimension of the nano scale, then it shows the quantum mechanical effects. Fourth one is the magnetic length. In the presence of magnetic inductance B, the electron energy is quantized in integral multiple of h nu c, where nu c is the cyclotron frequency. So nanostructure or low dimensional system. I already explained that nanostructure is any structure with one or more dimensions measuring in the nanometer range. Nanostructure consists of both self-assembled and directly fabricated materials. And nanostructures are typically probed either optically using spectroscopy or photoluminescence or in transport experiment. When you reduce the size from bulk to nano, some novel electrical, mechanical, chemical, magnetic, and optical properties can be introduced. And nanostructures are also called mesoscopic. Mesoscopic means they are intermediate between bulk and the smaller systems. For example, they are bigger than atomic or microscopic dimension, but small enough not to exhibit the ohmic properties. The resistance of a bulk material is given by R is equal to L upon sigma A, where L is the length, sigma is the conductivity, and A is the area of cross-section. A sample for which ever equation holds is called ohmic, and this behavior is well described. If the sample is small enough that the considering leading do not hold, then non-ohmic behavior can be resulted. The confinement of particle, usually electron holes, to a low dimensional structure leads to a dramatic change in their behavior and to the manifestation of size effects that falls under the category of quantum size effects. The low dimensional structure exhibit new physicochemical properties not shown by the corresponding larger scale structure, of the same composition. Overall, suitable control of properties and responses of nanostructure can lead to the new device and technologies. Now, the classification of low dimensions is very important to classify the low dimensional or nano scale systems. So, low dimensional systems are usually classified to the number of reduced dimensions they have. So, depending on their dimensionality, you can define on the basis of degree of freedom or confinement of the particles. So, if you talk about three-dimensional structure, or that is the bulk structure, there is no quantization of the particle in any direction. The particle is free to move in all three directions. Now, two-dimensional structure or quantum well, the quantization of the particle occurs in one direction. The particle is free to move in other two directions. That means we define or we classify the nanoscale system on the basis of degree of freedom. That means if they are free in two dimension, that is called two-dimensional. If they are free to move in one dimension, they are called the one dimension. So now, zero dimensional structure means particle is not free no more. That means the quantization occurs in all three directions. These are some examples in which you can understand the size of different nanoscale systems, like quantum well 1 to 1000 nanometer, quantum wires 1 to 100 nanometer, nanotube 1 to 100 nanometer, quantum dots 1 to 10 nanometer, and some thin film 10 to 500 nanometer. Now, physical behavior at the nanoscale is accurately predicted by quantum mechanics. As I already explained that when the size reduces from bulk to nano, then we cannot apply the classical mechanics. We have to apply the quantum mechanics represented by Schrödinger equation. The number of degrees of freedom in the electron motion together with the extent of confinement for the basic four-dimensional system given in the following table. This is just like a truth table that you can see that if degree of freedom is 3, then confinement in 0 direction. If degree of freedom is 0, then confinement in all 3 directions, that are the quantum dots. Now, we should understand quantum well, quantum wire, and quantum dot. The most significant nanostructure required to design nanoelectronic device are quantum wells, quantum wire, and quantum dots. They are the basic building block of nanoelectronic devices. Consider the examination result of 10th standard in UP board. Around 32 lakhs students appeared in the high school examination. Total 25.58 lakh students secured first division. Now consider the result of whole state as the first case. Result of a district, a school, and a classroom second, third, and fourth respectively. So if you plot the bar graph of the state level, then it will look like the case of bulk material where there is no limitation or no confinement, that they are free to move anywhere. In the second case, if you talk about the district level, it will resemble the case of quantum dot, because here the particle is free in one direction but confined in two directions. In the third case, if you talk about the school level result, there will be further reduction in the number of students. Now there is very similar to the structure of quantum wire. Finally, at the class level, each band will have very few number of students. This is analogous for the quantum dots. In nutshell, we can say that if we reduce the size of materials, more and more electrons can be confined and more activating controlling can be done at very low voltage and current levels. Now, the quantum well. Here, the term well referred to the semiconductor region that possesses lower energy, thus acting as a trap for the electrons. They are referred to as quantum wells, as these semiconductor regions are few atomic layer thick. That is why they are called quantum dots. And they act as a potential well for charge carrier, and that experimentally realized by epitaxial growth of sequence of ultra-thin layers. Now, two dissimilar semiconductors with different band gap can be joined together and to form a heterojunction. And the discontinuity in either the conduction or the valence band can be used to form the potential well. In a thin layer of narrower band gap material A, you can see here, the sandwich between two layers of wider band gap material B, that is actually here, so they form the double heterojunction. If layer A is sufficiently thin for the quantum properties to be exhibited, then such a band alignment is called single quantum well. Here you can see how they formed or synthesized. And if a stepped or asymmetric quantum well can be formed by the inclusion of an alloy between A and B, a still more complex structure can be formed, such as symmetric or asymmetric double quantum well. In a particular, a multiple quantum well exhibits the property of collection of isolated single quantum well, whereas in a superlattice, the quantum well also interact. All the above structure are example of type first systems. In type first system, the band gap of one material is nested entirely within the that of wider band gap material. As I described that some wider band gap material B and narrower band gap material A. Type second system, the band gap of the material say A and C are aligned such that quantum wells formed in the conduction and valence band are in different materials. They are occurring in the same material, but here they are occurring in different materials. Therefore, the electrons and holes are being confined in different layers of the semiconductors. Here you can see the type second. Now, in the previous slide, gallium arsenide or gallium 1 minus X, ALX, AS is the layered structure and constitute the in-plane motion of the charge carrier. One-dimensional potential is constructed from alternating thin layer of dissimilar semiconductors. Then the particles where it be electron or hole can move in the plane of the layers. Or we can then further reduce the dimensionality of the electron environment from a two-dimensional quantum well to one-dimensional quantum wire and eventually to the zero-dimensional quantum dots. So this is basically how to prepare quantum wire and quantum dot. In earlier slides, I showed how to prepare quantum well, but here you can see how the quantum wire and quantum dot can be prepared if you reduce the size. A standard quantum well layer can be patterned with photolithography or electron beam lithography and etched to leave a free standing strip, as you can see here, free standing strip of quantum well material. For example, the gallium aluminium arsenide. In addition to z-axis, the charge carriers can now be confined along an additional direction and either x or y depending on the lithography. So they confined in two dimension and free in only one direction. And now, how to prepare quantum wire and quantum dot in this system? The following figure shows an expanded view of single quantum wire where clearly the electron is free to move in only one direction, that is the y, in this case along the y-axis. And quantum dots can again be formed by further lithography and etching. For example, if a quantum well sample is etched to leave pillars rather than wires, then a charge carrier can become confined in all three dimensions. Actually, in case of quantum well, you see there is two dissimilar or similar semiconductors with wide or narrow band gap materials are joined together. And in case of quantum wire, you see that we made some strips or prepared some strips. But if you further do the lithography and quantum wire sample is etched to leave pillars like this, then it is confined in all three dimensions. So as you see that this is the example of class label, as I showed that 10th class result of UP board. So in this case, you can say the particle is confined in all three dimensions. Thank you very much for your kind attention. And here now we close.